in the summer, everything's coming up roses as long as Shirley's around. But now that the seasons are changing, Shirley is going to show us how to protect our beautiful rose bushes for the cold weather ahead so that we can have them the next year and the next year.
That's
it's
right.
important, right, Shirley?
It is really important. And it doesn't matter if you live in the cold, cold climate or in mild winter areas like us. There's a special technique that I'm going to show you today on how to fend for your roses so that they get through the winter in really good health.
This is all really great information, and I know this DIY was actually inspired by this weekend's premiere of Good Witch, Curse from a Rose, and we have a very special message from the stars, Catherine Bell and James Denton. Take a look.
Hi, Cameron and Debbie.
Welcome to the set of our new Good Witch Halloween event.
Let's take a look.
Good Witch Halloween event is always exciting. There's so much creativity and fun and play that goes into Halloween, and we have that on the show.
Yeah, we're shooting the big Halloween event, and we're doing always have a Halloween festival every year. Being out there with Mark Ben David in those pumpkin boats, rowing around in the lake. We're lucky we had good weather, and it was a fun day.
I think this newest Good Witch Halloween special is just, it's a fun ride.
Thanks for stopping by.
I know you're gonna love our new Good Witch Halloween event.
Watch for it this season on Hallmark Channel.
Happy Halloween.
I want to get in one.
I want to come visit them.
I know.
Thank you, guys. I can't wait to watch this Saturday on Hallmark Channel. It's going to be very exciting. All right, meanwhile, from pumpkins back to our roses.
Yeah, let's get to
it. How are we going to save them? Let's start with the milder climate.
Okay, yeah. Like, bushes. You know, here's the thing, guys. If you're living in a mild climate like we do, you basically can grow roses all year round. But that doesn't mean that we don't treat them special during this fall, going into wintertime, because we want to really start coaxing our rose to take a little break.
Okay.
I mean, don't just keep pumping out flowers.
Sure.
And the way we do that is like this. First of all, I want to just give it a little trim. When you see any of the stems that are growing inside towards the middle, that isn't good for air circulation, so I'm going to give it just a light little pruning.
And those were kind of yellow anyway.
Yeah, kind of yellow, which is going to be the next subject. So look around for any of the stems that are dead, that are broken, and make sure to remove them. This one looks kind of bad. But there's a yellow issue that you just talked about.
Okay.
I want you guys to notice that we have some leaves here that are yellowing. They have brown spot. Now, this is the beginning of a fungus, and it's not good because roses are very, very vulnerable to that. So the minute you see...
So that's not malnutrition. That's fungus.
No, that is fungus, and it happens when you have warm days and cool nights like we do.
Okay.
And so first thing you do, Debbie, is you remove as many of the diseased leaves as possible.
Okay.
I'm not going to be able to do all of them now, but then the next thing is to get yourself a fungicide that is for roses, and the most important thing is that you apply it properly. So you're going to totally drench the front, the back, the leaves, and you're going to go throughout the whole plant, and you're going to do this once a week.
So you're getting it really wet.
And you're going to get it really, really wet.
Okay.
And that is how you treat the fungus. Now, the last thing you want to do is give your roses in mild climates the very last fertilization of the year. So I've got a really mild rose solution here. I'm going to scratch it in after watering. And just like this.
But why would you want to fertilize it if you don't want it to grow
right
now?
Well, because we still have a little bit of time, maybe another flush. After that, we're going to coax it to sleep.
Okay.
But that is it. That is the last fertilization, and then you water it. And basically, you just keep an eye on it. Make sure that it gets water if it's not raining, which, of course, it never rains out here.
Okay.
And
so
that is it.
Gonna,
it's very easy.
That's in mild climates like here in Southern California. But
correct.
For the rest of the country, the rest of the world, this is what you're going to be doing.
Okay,
so
yeah.
Do it for the colder climate.
Okay, rule of thumb. Don't fertilize anymore. I mean, after August, really, you don't want to be fertilizing because we don't want to encourage growth. The second thing is you want to wait. We're going to insulate this, and we're going to protect it from the snow and the freezing weather.
Okay.
So what you do is you wait until your first hard frost because we want this to actually become frozen.
Why?
Because when we keep it in an altered state, in a frozen state, without it thawing, we want to keep it frozen, then it can survive and slowly melt into the spring. But if we have thawing and if we have freezing at the same time, you're going to burst cells throughout your stems and through the root system, and that is a certain death. So really, we're going to just pour a little bit of soil around the root area, like this, about 12 inches, and then we're going to layer it. We're going to let this freeze.
Again?
Yeah, because it's freezing, remember?
Okay.
Let's pretend.
Okay.
Okay, it's freezing. So now this is frozen. Now we're going to do the second part. We're going to add a cage. We're using a tomato cage here with some insulation material.
Okay.
And I want to just show that to you, how it's open, just like this. But you know what? We can show them what's going to happen. So we're
brush
using this kind of thing. Yes. And then because this is wood, we can go ahead and staple this.
Wrap it around.
I think we can we?
There we go. You got it.
All right. You guys get the idea, right?
Okay. So you staple
okay.
this here.
Now, remember I said that we were going to let the soil freeze? Now we want to insulate that frozen soil so it doesn't melt. So it's another layer.
So like another blanket.
Exactly. So now okay. we're going to fill it with some lightweight leaves. And then we're gonna cover the top.
And then staple that guy again.
Staple that sucker in, because really what we want is, if you have a warm day, we wanna be able to have that that heat, you know, go through and not stay within here. Cause it's like we're creating an insulation blanket. So that's it. Let it freeze and then keep it frozen until spring.
So much great information. And then Shirley, you'll have beautiful roses.
Oh yeah.
When spring comes around.
Forever.
Thank you, Shirley. You can get more information about Shirley's garden projects at edenmaker.com.